Very good morning, dear students. Welcome you all for video lectures on the subject Indian Banking. In the previous class, we discussed commercial banks, functions of commercial banks, etc. Today, we are going to understand very briefly RRBs and the prudential norms of RBA. See, first, regional rural banks. Regional rural banks were established in the year 1975 under the provisions of ordinance promulgated on 26th September 1975 with a view to developing the rural economy. Here you can very easily understand that the RRB, regional rural, this bank purely meant for the economic development of rural areas. So in order to introduce these banks, the special act ordinance was promulgated on 26 September 1975. With this, that the rural banks came into existence in the year 1975. So here, the main aim of rural banks are to improve the economic standards of rural population. The aggregate deposits and advances of all RRBs, that is on 31st March 2014 stood at rupees 41.034 crores. So it shows how the rural, the regional rural banks improved in managing the deposits and advances. So here the regional rural banks started effectively growing. That is in terms of mobilizing the funds and by way of sanctioning the loans and advances to the rural people in order to help them to manage their provisions. The bulk of the loans are to provide for priority sector. Say whatever the advances and loans, the regional rural banks sanction especially for priority sector. Priority sector is the agricultural sector. So here, within the rural area, the agricultural laborers, rural artisans, and other weaker sections who are carrying their activities related to agriculture is the priority sector. Therefore, here, all including the small or medium industrial units that will produce the instruments or equipment required for managing the agriculture will also come under the category priority sector. Therefore, here the bulk of the loans, the various types of loans are offered by regional rural banks, especially for priority sector in rural areas. Local area banks. So the scheme was introduced in addition to RRB in August 1996. The scheme enables to mobilize rural savings and make them available for investments in local areas, like Gramina banks. That is the local area banks. Cooperative, other rural cooperative banks were also established in order to provide the financial assistance for locals. Now here, the main topic is banking reforms after 1990. The main objective of the reforms initiated in the 1990s was to create an efficient, competitive and a stable financial sector that could contribute to the economic growth. The number of reforms were brought by the government of India in order to improve the efficiency and competitive level of the banking sector. So the important achievements are financial markets, competition among financial intermediaries helped the interest rates to decline. Deregulation added to it. Borrowers did not pay a high price while depositors had incentive to save. Here, the banking reforms are very, very essential in order to achieve the growth of the financial markets. In financial markets, when there was no competition, that the private lenders were charging abnormal rates and looting the beneficiaries. So, in order to bring change in the financial markets, that the liberalization in the banking sector was essential. Therefore, the banking reforms were brought in the year 1990. So here, when there is huge competition among the financial intermediaries, automatically that the interest rates charged by the private lenders will come down. The deregulation added to it, liberalization of the banking operations, the restrictions or regulations were also, reduced. We call it as deregulation, so that there is a freedom for the finance, there is a banking sector in order to lend the loans for the beneficiaries. And here, when the deregulation is brought, automatically the borrowers will be able to obtain the loans at lower rate of interest. At the same time, that the depositors of the banks will get the, incentive, higher, that is a high rate of interest. The depositors definitely will come forward to deposit their funds only in banks because of guarantee of the money what they invest, though there is somewhat low rate of interest compared to the private lenders or private banks. Therefore, here, in order to change the financial markets, update the financial markets, the banking reforms were brought. Regulators. Government accepted the role of regulators. As such, RBI, SEBI, IRDA, Integrated Rural Development Authority, have become important institutions. So, as a part of reforms, the government is also considered to act as a regulator, along with Reserve Bank of India, SEBI, Stock Exchange Board of India, IRDA, etc. So here, when all, along with the bank, like RBI, SEBI, IRDA, considered as a regulator, they will design appropriate guidelines, the procedures to be followed by money lenders, banks, including the financial institutions. So when there are restrictions or regulations, the misutilization of the, finance will not happen. As a result, that the existence of risk, level of risk, can be minimized. So here, that regulations also will help a lot under the reforms. The banking system, almost 80% of the business controlled by the public sector banks. Public sector banks are dominating commercial banking system. Shares of public sector banks are listed in the stock exchange. RBI has given licenses to new private banks. is a part of a liberalization further granted to industrial houses. Reforms were brought especially for the banking system. You know well, 80% of the business is controlled by the public sector banks. They are dominating the commercial banking system, the public sector. Therefore, the shares of PSBs are listed in the stock exchange. The buying and selling of the shares of the public sector banks are carried through the stock exchanges, means that the performance of the public sector bank was recognized. In addition to that, the reforms, under the reforms, RBI has given the license to new private banks as a part of the liberalization, because the new, along with the public sector banks, when new private banks were permitted to operate, it means that there is a competition. So because of the competition, automatically the effective functioning of the banks will improve. Finally, that the benefits will go to the users of the banks, the borrowers, depositors, and others. Further granted to industrial houses. So that means that the reforms are especially important to bring change, updation, development in the banking system. Non-banking finance companies seeking registration with RBI, the requirement of minimum owned funds raised to rupees 2 crore. Non-banking finance companies like insurance companies, foreign exchange currencies, Institute of Foreign Currency Exchanges, and other capitalists like venture capitalists, all will come under the category non-banking financial companies. So here they need registration. They seek registration with the Reserve Bank of India. Therefore, the requirement of minimum owned cash fund under the reforms raises to rupees 2 crores. Without this, 2 crores of fund, minimum owned fund, no non-banking financial institutions are allowed to get a registration with the Reserve Bank of India. Until recently, money market in India was narrow and dominated by tight regulations, over interest rates and participants. So here, that the money market in India was narrow. It was dominated by tight regulations over interest rates and participants. So in order to liberalize, we brought the reforms in a non-banking financial company. The secondary market was underdeveloped, lacked liquidity. Secondary market, where once the shares are issued and this is same shares will be purchased and sold in the secondary market. It was not well developed earlier. So in order to improve that, the reforms are very essential under non-banking finance company. Several measures have been initiated, including the setting up of Discount Finance House of India. Coming to capital markets, the number of shareholders in India estimated at 25 million. Only 2 lakh persons actively traded in stock. Dramatic improvement in stock market trading infrastructure. So in order to improve the capital market, the procurement of funds by way of issuing the equity shares, preference shares, and even issue of debentures and other bonds. So here, once the stock market is well established, we can attract n number of shareholders. At present, 25 million shareholders are only 2 lakh persons are actively traded in Asst. So in order to motivate them, in order to help them to participate actively in trading, the stock market was well developed and the participants are facilitated in order to participate in the trade market, so that the capital market will be flourished. Mutual funds. You know about mutual fund. The small saving holders cannot invest, that means in the shares of the reputed companies. So here under mutual funds, that the after mobilizing the small savings of n number of investors, that the mutual fund authority will plan to invest their funds in appropriate places, that is shares or bonds or whatever, facilitating the small savers, that means saving holders, to enjoy the more earnings or benefits. With this, many more players, both India and foreign players, also actively participate. The Unit Trust of India remains biggest mutual fund with a corpus of rupees 70,000 crore. So here, that the mutual funds, when once it is regulated under the SEBI regulations, that they are functioning well. So when that the mutual funds are functioning well, it is a benefit to the small savers. In order to do that, the bank reforms are essential under the sector. Overall approach to reforms. The government and the regulatory authorities have followed step by step approach, overall approach to reforms. So when the government, RBI, SEBI and others considered as regulatory authorities, they followed the guidelines step by step. And the entry for foreign players and technology developments are also encouraged under the reforms. Deregulation of banking system. The banking system, that the tight regulations were relaxed. Deregulation is introduced. Prudential norms were introduced for income recognition. Prudential norms, the guidelines, the procedure that we need to follow for recognizing the income, classifying the assets, provision of loans, and capital adequacy. So here, under the deregulation of banking system, that the specific guidelines were introduced in order to recognize the income, even classification of the assets, especially, some of the assets may not be having the source of earning. So those assets will be considered. Dead assets, and this classification, in order to classify these, there are guidelines issued by the Reserve Bank of India under the system reforms. To reach substantial capital adequacy, government capital to public sector banks, that means from government to public sector banks, that in order to maintain the substantial capital adequacy, the reforms are essential. And here also SLR, statutory liquidity ratio, CRR, cash reserve ratio, also brought down step by step, so that the availability of the money within the banks are sufficient, resulting in capital adequacy. New private sector banks were allowed. New private sector banks to promote and encourage competition. That means only public sector banks are encouraged by the government, and that the competition will not exist. So in order to create competition among the banks, that the new public private sector banks were encouraged, so that efficient operation among the banks is possible. Finally, the benefits will be available for the public. Capital market development. Capital market development. See, the capital market regulator was established in 1992. In order to regulate the capital market, I mean SEBI, the Stock Exchange Board of India, was introduced in 1992. Foreign institutional investors were allowed to invest in Indian capital markets after registration with SEBI. Therefore, here, foreign institutional investors are also permitted to invest in the Indian capital market. So, after getting registered with the SEBI, Indian companies access to international capital markets with euro issue. Indian companies will have the access to international capital. So, NSE with a nationwide stock trading electronic display. Several local stock exchanges changed from floor-based trading to screen-based trading. There is online trading was possible because of the capital market developments. So here we came to understand what are the several reforms were brought in order to improve the banking system in India. So with this, we completed very briefly the results, RRBs, local banks, and various reforms brought in order to improve the banking system in India. Thank you. With a new topic, we'll see in the next class.